Of two young witches who are joined by a powerful bond. From this time forth, it must forever remain a secret, never to be repeated.
Back in the forest? Huh? Cheshire? Where are you, Cheshire?
Trapped within a strange void, Ceresa had been petrified by a mysterious force. And as for Cheshire, he was nowhere to be seen. Could this too have been the work of the fairies?
My thanks. The fairies' power resonated through me. I'm surprised that one so young was able to resist my power. But I should have, if only.
Oh no. I figured she could handle that forest without my help. But this... it goes against all Umbran teachings. But I have no choice.
For years, this young girl had protected Ceresa, always being sure to watch over her from afar. Unlike Ceresa, Jean lived in the Umbra Witch Village. Though forbidden, she often Jean had been warned about the risks of soul projection, but that stayed her hand. For she aspired to surpass Ceresa and become the strongest of all the Umbra Witches, a goal that allowed no...
I swear... a girl likes to keep me busy!
Jean's technique
I'm sure of it now. Something is afoot in this forest. Ceresa, where are you?
Jean.
So this is the infamous fairy forest. But there's something else here. I'm sure of it. The Elder would really give me an earful if she knew I was here. Whatever. I'm used to her lectures. Sariza, where are you? That girl. Always getting herself into trouble. What is that?
As Jean proceeded through the woods.
Is that... Sarai...
As I thought...
Who are you?
Cheshire's voice...
Who's there?
Don't play dumb. You trapped me in here, didn't you?
But it took all his strength just to keep from...
You're... a demon.
Sariza? How do you know the girl?
I'm an Umbra witch. Apprentice. Jean, I've come to save Sariza. What have you done with her? Get out here and explain yourself.
Boom. Like I know where that brat is.
Cheshire's...
Wait, a demon? Here? Did Sariza summon...
Jean knew Sariza well. Seeing the demon-possessed stuff, she thought for a moment.
I've a proposition for you, demon. I'll get you unstuck. But in return...
Fine, Sariza.
That's the deal. If you say you'll help me, I'll move you to a body in a...
Jean produced a stuffed animal of her own. Compared to Cheshire's tattered felt.
Like I trust a human.
Yep. Fine by me. Best of luck, then.
Jean turned her back on the prideful deep.
Wait!
Cheshire yelled, and with good reason.
All right, let me into that blasted cat.
Very well, deep. To think this would come in handy.
I don't have one.
I see.
Charles?
Perhaps the demon had grown more attached to the name Cheshire.
What's the fuss? Sooner than expected. I've held up my end of the bargain. Now earn your keep.
Cheshire was not fond of his new name, but now was not the time. Any protest would have to wait. Thus began Jean and Jean and Charles search for Sariza.
Just now.
Thank you.
What are these cracks? Fairy tricks? What is this place? The fairy stench is overwhelming.
Yes, this place is always crawling with them. Perfect for a quick snack.
The demon had learned a few things on his journey, so he took this opportunity to show off.
You know that little crybaby.
Charles eyed John suspiciously as he spoke.
Crybaby? Oh, you mean Ceresa. She may blubber from time to time, but look past the tears and you'll find a truly spectacular power. Ceresa and I have a duty to become stronger. We must protect the legacy of the Umbra.
Ha!
said, well, I'm not surprised she summoned a demon into a stuffed cat. And I dare say, you seem to like it.
Like it? I'm counting down the seconds till she gets me back to Inferno.
John thought that Charles's felt cheeks looked more red than usual.
Razor. She's close by, I can feel it. Where?
Charles heard John, but said nothing. Deep down, worry weighed heavy on his heart. He let out a sigh.
Father, and you will regret it.
Who's there?